Hi everyone, my name is Leah Kopke and I'm a 3D motion design freelancer. I also have a podcast where each week I cover another 3D modeling tool for Cinema 4D. Hello and welcome. Today we're going to be talking about N-gons, how to work with them and how to remove them. We'll go through all the tools relating to N-gons and a little bit of how to fix them, since they aren't the best actually for your 3D modeling topology. So we're going to go over retriangulate N-gons, a tool called N-gon triangulation, and another tool called remove N-gons. So let's go ahead and jump into Cinema 4D and get started. So we have this really handy tool over here while in model mode. I can see this over here on this tool bar, and this is called Polygon Pen. We are going to cover this in depth in the future. I was saving it for later since it's one of the tools for 3D modeling that has the most settings, so I thought it would be easier to take in once we've covered some other tools first. But we are getting close to covering this. But just briefly, I'm going to click on this tool and we're going to use it to create an example for this. If I hit the middle mouse button, I can see my quads, my four views, and I'll go into our top view here by hitting the middle mouse button again. We've gone over how to use the snap before, so I'll leave a link to that episode below, but I'm going to enable my snap for right now, and I'm going to snap to my grid. I want to snap to the grid points and grid lines, and I'm going to use this new tool we're talking about for right now called the Polygon Pen in order to create ourselves an N-gon. So we'll get started. I'm going to click a point here and we're snapping to our grid. I'm just drawing out a general shape here. I'm going to move down a little bit. Each time I click, I'm creating a point. And what I'm basically doing right here is creating a giant N-gon. An N-gon is a polygon with more than four sides. You usually don't want it in your model. I can't think of a situation in which you would want this in your model, but it's a common thing to come across while 3D modeling, so it's still good to talk about. So here we have a giant N-gon. If we turn on our shading lines, you can see that there are no edges in here, that this has a ton of points, and you can see that it's completely flat. It's right here. So the first thing to understand about N-gons is that you may not be able to see that they are made up of quads and triangles, but they actually are. You just can't see it. But it can really make 3D modeling messy, so at some point you're going to want to convert this to triangles and quads, and I'd suggest using all quads and avoiding triangles. There's some exceptions to having triangles in your model, but most of the time, just avoid them in general. Some software does require you to have everything in triangles, like if you're taking something into Unreal Engine from Cinema 4D, it's actually good to triangulate your model beforehand, and I'll leave a link to the episode about that. But just for right now, I can't think of a situation to really want N-gons. We have a lot of 3D modeling tools for N-gons, though. You can see them listed under the N-gons menu, and you'll see the hotkeys are listed next to them. You have N-gon triangulation, which the hotkey for that is UT. Retriangulate N-gons, the hotkey for that is UG. And remove N-gons, and the hotkey for that is UE. For right now, I'm going to click this dotted border at the top here just so that I can separate that. And now I have this over here. I think that's looking pretty good, that we just have these tools easy to access. You can, of course, dock them over to the side if you'd like to. But moving forward, as I said, this N-gon is made up of triangles that we cannot see, and quads are even made up of triangles. So we can actually see this if we go in our filter and we go all the way down to N-gon lines and we click this on, it'll allow us to see that. So you can see that Cinema 4D is actually breaking up this N-gon. If I zoom in really close here, you can see this line here, this cyan looking line. That's showing where Cinema 4D is actually calculating that this is a quad. So it's actually breaking this up into quads, and quads are made up of triangles. That's a little bit of the theory behind it, because it needs to do that in order to do calculations. What we're going to do now is talk about some of the errors that you can come about if you have N-gons. So first of all, they just make it hard to use any of the 3D modeling commands. A common error is that if you move a point and you cross this line that's usually invisible, you'll end up with this really weird looking thing here where it's flickering and there's some black looking polygons. This is signifying to you that there is an error, because this is overlapping that over there, and that's not good. It's not good for anything. You don't want to render with that. Don't do it. So one of the helpful tools in here to fix that, if you do run into that issue, is you can click retriangulate N-gons, and it will redraw these cyan lines showing where the quads are in order to create that. I'm going to hit undo here for a moment and put that back the way it was. There's also this other tool called N-gon triangulation. And if you click that, you'll see that it remains purple, because this is actually a command that stays on. And the idea behind this command is that it's like retriangulate N-gons, except that it auto updates in real time every time you move a point that runs into that error. Now you can see that I'm still running into that error, N-gon triangulation. It doesn't always work the way you expect it to. Every other tool that I've really covered in Cinema 4D so far, this is the first tool where it doesn't necessarily work 100% all the time for me. So I think that it's best to go with retriangulate N-gons, but honestly, you shouldn't even need to have N-gon triangulation on, because you shouldn't even have this issue to begin with where you have an N-gon in your model. It's not good. No reason to have it. I'm going to hit undo again. So the interesting thing is that there's this third option here called remove N-gons. You can click on this and it will remove the N-gons by creating actual edges. And you can get a good preview of where those edges will be by clicking on this N-gon lines. That will give you an idea of where those edges will be. If I click remove N-gons now, you can see that now those lines are much darker. They're actually there. We are not relying on this N-gon lines. I can click on that, it's off, but we're still seeing those edges. So that's one way to fix it. And even if I just hit undo, and even if you decide to have a different type of shape, if I were to click remove N-gons, you can see that the updated edges will become your main edges once you click remove N-gons. So this made this into a quad and a few triangles, another quad here and another quad here. So that gives you an idea of how to go about that. What if that's not exactly the topology that we'd like for that? We could draw our own using the line cut tool, and I've covered the line cut tool before. The hotkey for it is MK. So we could have the line cut tool. Now the idea here is that you want to imagine in your mind how you can slice this, dissolve this, in order to change these triangles to quads. And I'll leave a link to the line cut tool, as well as the dissolve tool and the melt tool, so that if you want to learn more about those, you can. I'm going to want to use these triangles here to make quads, but there are some areas where we just don't need this. So if I click on this edge here and I want to get rid of it to fix this end gone and give it some nicer topology, there's a few different ways you could think about it. So we have the dissolve tool, and the dissolve tool, the hotkey for it is MN, and that gets rid of points. So if we use the dissolve tool, it will also get rid of this point here. And in that case, we want to do that. If we use the melt tool, it will get rid of this edge, but keep the point. So we're going to use the dissolve here. So I'll use the hotkey MN. And that's why it's good to know the difference between dissolve and melt, because it makes your life easier. So now we have a triangle here, and that's still a problem. But the thing about triangles is that if you put two triangles together, they make a quad. So we actually need to make this quad over here into another triangle in order to fix this. So we're going to use the line cut tool, MK, and I'm going to click here, I'm going to click here, and I'm going to hit escape. So now we have a new edge there, and we need to get rid of this edge. But this time we want to keep the point, so we're going to use the melt tool, and the melt tool is UZ. That's the hotkey for it. So now we have one quad here, and we have one quad here. So now this is looking a little bit better. We need to fix this area here. So here we have an edge, and this edge isn't necessary. It's not doing anything. We don't need the point along this edge either. So to remove all of the points that are unnecessary, we'll use the hotkey MN for dissolve. So now this area here is a triangle, and we don't need triangles in our geometry. It's not good. So we'll use the hotkey MK again, and we'll create a cut there, and we'll take these two triangles and we'll use the hotkey UZ to melt it so that we keep this point here. You can actually see what happens if I hit undo and use the wrong hotkey, and I use if I use MN, you can see it removes that point and changes the shape of it. So we don't want to do that. We want to melt this instead of dissolve this. Now we have two triangles here. So in this case, we want to remove the point. So we can use the hotkey MN. So now we have a triangle here. What if we don't want a triangle there? Well, what makes a triangle no longer a triangle is adding a point to make it a quad. So what we need to do is use the knife cut tool to remove this triangle. So I clicked here. I'm going to click out here and hit escape. So that actually went ahead and added in this point over here, so that now this is a quad, this is a quad, this is a quad. All of these are made up of quads, so that fixed our topology here. And that's one easy way to change a triangle to being a quad. And that's one way to remove your n-gons from your mesh. So I hope you found this tutorial helpful. If you have any questions in regards to n-gons, or triangles or quads or any of that, please let me know, and I'm happy to answer any questions you have. You can leave them in the comments below, and thank you so much for 3D modeling with me. Each episode we go over another 3D modeling tool for Cinema 4D, so I hope I'll see you here again next week.